स्वेच्छा केसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः प्रायन्ताम्बूमधुरतोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नकाः. अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः तु अन्यः यत्र अर्थः स प्रकाशते यः तात्पर्येण वस्तु अन्यत् व्यनक्ति उक्तिं विना स्वतः. वि फिनिश्ड् शब्दशक्ति उद्भवः. नौ वि आर् गोयिङ्ग् टु लुक् एट् अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः. दिस् इस् द डेफिनेशन् आफ् अर्थशक्ति उद्भवतुनि. यत्र अर्थः स्वतः उक्तिं विना प्रकाशते. द कारिका अन्वयम् इस् अ लिटिल् बिट् डिफिकल्ट्. इट् गोस् अप् अण्ड् डौन् द फस्ट् लैन् एण्ड् द सेकेण्ड् लैन्. सो लेट्स् लुक् एट् इट्. सो मीनिङ्ग् यत्र अर्थः यः स्वतः उक्तिं विना प्रकाशते. वेन् द मीनिङ्ग् मेनिफेस्ट्स् बै इट् सेल्फ् विदौट् डिपेण्डिङ्ग् आन् अभिध or without the word being mentioned in the shloka itself. If the meaning that you get, if the artha dvani is, that is, it does not depend on the word. If I change the vachaka shabda also, then I still will have artha shakti, artha, what is that? Okay, she's joined. Okay, so even if the word is changed, still that dhvani is not lost. Sometimes in Shabda Shakti Udbhava, the examples that we saw are, if the words are changed, then the whole dhvani is lost. It does not depend on the meaning. If it depends on the meaning, then the word Shabda Parivritti Sahatvam Vartate Tat. So Yatra Arthaha स्वसामर्थ्यात् अर्थान्तरम् अभिव्यनक्ति शब्दव्यापारं विना एव. दट्स् वाट् इट् मीन्स्. शब्दव्यापारं विना मीन्स् इट् डजन्ट् मीन् देर् इस् नो अभिधा एट् आल्. यु नीड् दि अभिधा टु हाव् द वाच्यक शब्द गिव् यू द वाच्यार्थ. फ्रम् दट् वाच्यार्थ विच् डस् नाट् देन् डिपेण्ड् आन् द वर्ड् टु गिव् मी द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ. सो दट् इस् वाट् हि मीन्स् बै स्वतः उक्तिं विना. उक्तिं विना स्वतः अन्यत् वस्तु व्यनक्ति. वेन् इट् गिव्स् मी, वेन् इट् सजेस्ट्स् एन् अदर् वस्तु, सः अन्यः अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः. अन्यः मीन्स् शब्दशक्ति उद्भवात् अन्यः अर्थशक्ति उद्भवो नाम ध्वनिः. ओके, सो अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः तु अन्यः यत्र अर्थः सः प्रकाशते यः तात्पर्येण. लेट् द तात्पर्येण बि सेपरेट्. Deal with that later. So the vastu anyat vyanakti uktim vina svataha. So as the karika says, yatra artaha swasamartyat arthantaram abhivyanakti. When it suggests another meaning, shabda vyaparam vinaiva, without depending on the word per se, not abhidam vina, but without depending on the word. It doesn't abhidam vina व्यञ्जनाशक्तिम् उपयुज्य सः अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः नाम अनुस्वान उपम व्यङ्ग्यः ध्वनिः. ओके, सो दट् तात्पर्येण आनन्दवर्धन डस् नाट् एक्स्प्लेन् इन् हिस् वृत्ति, बट् इट् इस् ओन्ली एक्स्प्लेन्ड् बै लोचनकार. हि स्पेसिफिक्ली सेस्, अभिनवगुप्ता सेस्, तात्पर्येण अभिधाव्यापारनिराकरणपरम् इदं पदं ध्वननव्यापारम् आह न तु तात्पर्यशक्तिः. नाट् न तु तात्पर्यशक्तिं. तात्पर्यशक्ति इस् अनदर्. तात्पर्यम् इस् अनदर् व्यापार वेर् इट् इस् द वक्तृ इच्छा प्रतिपादकः. इट् गिव्स् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् वाट् द पोयट् आर् वाट् द स्पीकर् विशस् टु कन्वे. दट् इस् द तात्पर्यम्. ऐ मे से डोण्ट् गो देर्, आर् ऐ मे से, you know, it to imply don't go. I mean, say okay, go fall in the well, which means it is equal to falling in the well. Do not put yourself in such a danger, such a disastrous position. So that is the tatparyam. That is the vachya. Vaktra iccha is your tatparyam. Okay, so vyanjana here, it is not that tatparya shakti he uses, whereas it is vyanjana vyapara that he says, he indicates by the word tatparyam. Tatparyam is अभिधा अन्यत् अभिधा व्यापार निराकरण परम् इदम्. टु नेगेट् अभिधा, टु से दट्, टु एक्स्क्लूड् अभिधा फ्रम् दिस् होल् थिङ्ग्, हि यूसस् द वर्ड् तात्पर्यम्, नाट् टु इण्डिकेट् तात्पर्य शक्ति. ओके, सो यथा च द उदाहरणं हि गिव्स् हियर् इस् एवं वादिनी देवर्षौ पार्श्वे पितुरधोमुखी लीलाकमलपत्राणि गणयामास पार्वती आर् गणयामास केवलम्. अत्र हि लीलाकमलपत्रगणनम् उपसर्जनीकृतस्वरूपं शब्दव्यापारं विनैव अर्थान्तरं व्यभिचारिभावलक्षणं प्रकाशयति. सो हियर् अर्थान्तरं मीन्स् लज्जारूपं व्यभिचारिभावं प्रकाशयति. सो वाट् इस् द मीनिङ्ग् आफ् दिस्? देवर्षौ पार्श्वे एवं वादिनी देवर्षौ पार्श्वे एवं वादिनी देवर्षौ सति. देन् नारद केम् एण्ड् सेड् इन् दिस् मेनर् पार्श्वे पितुः पार्श्वे नियर् हर् फादर् पार्वती अधोमुखी स्थिता सति लीलाकमलपत्राणि गणयामास. शी हेड् अ लोटस् इन् हर् हेण्ड् एण्ड् वेन् नारद स्पोक् दस् she stood with lowered face adhomukhi with her face looking on the at the ground leela kamala patrani she had a lotus in her hand which is like a leela for just for sportively she had a lotus in her hand and tasya kamalasya patrani ganayamasa she was counting she doesn't want to count that it is her lajja her shyness that is revealed when we just hear these words. So here that counting is actually upasarjani krita swaroopam. It becomes, it subordinates itself here. It is upasarjani kritam means it is not the pradhanam here. Leela kamala patra gananam is not pradhanam here. It reveals the vyabhichari bhava lajja. She has to do something here. She cannot just directly, like a proudha naika, she cannot look at her father's face expectantly. Okay, are you going to, you know, do something about the situation here? She's not going to look at, see, the time frame matters, right? Today, if someone comes and tells you, you know, there is this person, okay, just give me the number. I want to have a contact with him or let me WhatsApp him. That is the age we are in today. Nobody is going to look at her hand or foot or anything. But in that age, it is such a sweet expression and the scene is also very cute that way, right? So she instead of looking at either Narada for giving such a suggestion or looking at her father to say what is the next course of action, she didn't know how to express. She was feeling shy. So she was looking at something which is there in her hand or, you know, likhan naaste. There is another shlokam in Amarushatakam, I think. Likhan naaste bhumau. She was just writing something with her big toe on the bhumi. Likhan naaste means that is an expression of lajja too. So she doesn't know what to do, doesn't know how to approach the situation. At the same time, she is feeling shy to approach also. So she kept on moving her fingers this way and that way, fidgeting something or the other. When you don't want to jump into the situation. So atrahi leela kamala patra gananam upasarjani krita swarupam shabdavyaparam vinaiva arthantaram shabdavyaparam vinaiva. You can change leela kamala patrani. You can change it to likhannaste. Anguli bihi likhannaste. That is also possible. Right? So the artham is what gives us that vyabhichari bhava lajja. Anything you can change. Or leela utpalavatrani ganayamasa. You can even change the flower there. You don't need ganayamasa. Or just sprishanna aste. She was just touching it. Or she was fiddling with it. Some word can be used. It doesn't matter. So shabda vyaparam vina means it does not come back to that word. And it is only by the, it is not by the force of that word that you have the vyangyartham. Okay, so vyabhichari bhava lakshanam prakashayati. Next is now he goes to the discussion part about whether this is an asamlakshya karmadhvani or an arthashakti udbhavadhvani. So nacha ayam asamlakshya krama alakshya krama vyangyasyaiva dvanehe vishayah. Now this is a, someone can say this is bhavadhvani. Okay, bhavadhvani comes about when there is a proper vibhava, anubhava, etc. Okay, सो न च अयम् अलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यस्यैव ध्वनेः विषयः. दिस् इस् नाट् अ भावध्वनि अलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यम् असमलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्य, यतः यत्र साक्षात् शब्दनिवेदितेभ्यः विभाव अनुभाव व्यभिचारिभ्यः रसादीनां प्रतीतिः स तस्य केवलस्य मार्गः. तस्य असंलक्ष्यक्रमस्य केवलस्य असंलक्ष्यक्रमस्यैव मार्गः कुत्र? इदिल अदादु वाट् इस् दट् साक्षात् शब्दनिवेदितेभ्यः विभाव अनुभाव व्यभिचारिभ्यः. वेर् एवर् द विभाव इस् मेन्शन्ड् हियर् देर् इस् नो द ब्यूटि आफ् her is not mentioned here. Okay, so Parvati's beauty as an alambana vibhava is not mentioned, nor is there Shiva's beauty mentioned, Shiva's handsomeness mentioned for us to understand the greatness of an alambana vibhava or an uddipana vibhava. There is no uddipanam here. Maybe evam vadini can be taken as an uddipanam, where he the words are kindling that effect, but still it is not as beautiful as the lajja dhvani which comes from the force of the meaning of leela kamalapatrani ganayamasa gananam, from there only. So only where you have a description of vibhava or anubhava or vyabhichari bhava and there is a rasam, that is where you have the rasa bhava tadabhasa etc etc. Yatha, now he gives an example for asamlakshikrama vyangya. If you take the same example in Kavya Prakasha, where he says then vyaparayamasa vilochanani, there he says it is a sandigdha pradhanyam gunibhuta vyangyam. But here Anandavardhana gives that as an example for uttama rasadhvani shloka, and he gives the entire passage in adena lochanam. I wanted to quote that. See, यत्र हि विभाव अनुभावेभ्यः स्थायीगतेभ्यः व्यभिचारिगतेभ्यश्च पूर्णेभ्यः झटिति एव रसव्यक्तिः तत्र तु अलक्ष्यक्रमः. सो यत्र साक्षात् शब्दनिवेदितेभ्यः, दट् इस् द मीनिङ्ग् हि गिव्स् हियर्. सी, यत्र विभाव अनुभावेभ्यः स्थायीगतेभ्यः, इफ् इट् इस् देर् इन् द स्थायीभावम्, and vyabhicharigatebhyah, or it should be in the vyabhichari bhavam, purnebhyah eva jhatiti eva rasa vyaktihi tatra, only there you have asamlakshikramadhvani and not in evam vadini devarsho. So yatha, if you look at the text, it is yatha kumarasambhave madhuprasange, यथा कुमारसम्भवे मधुप्रसङ्गे वसन्तपुष्प आभरणं वहन्त्याः देव्याः आगमनादिवर्णनं मनोभवशरसन्धानपर्यन्तं शम्भोश्च परिवृत्तधैर्यस्य चेष्टाविशेषवर्णनादि साक्षात् शब्दनिवेदितम् इह तु. दट् इस् इह तु इस् फोर् एवं वादिनि देवर्षो. सो फोर् दिस् यूल् हाव् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दिस् एण्टैर् लैन् आफ् हौ इन् कुमारसम्भव इन् दट् सेक्षन् यू हाव् दट् asamlakshikramam vyangyam. We have to look at lochanam, otherwise there is no point in just reading that line just like that. So yatha kumara sambhave madhu prasange, in the third act madhumasa comes in, and everybody, it is an akala madhu prasanga. Nobody was expecting vasantaritu to come about at that time, and so nobody, all the animals and the rishis did not know how to behave. They were suddenly, you know, even rishis, siddhanganaha, those who they are constantly thinking about parabrahman and all that, they are beyond desires like this, but suddenly when madhumasa attacks you, you are unprepared for it, you do not expect the spring season to come, and so their chitta vikara is at its maximum now. Suddenly there is a change of mind. So everybody, when the entire forest is behaving and reacting, not behaving, it is reacting to this change in the season, so even Shiva will naturally get affected by it, right? Nirvana bhuyishtam athasya viryam sandukshayanti. So but Shiva is completely unaffected by it, and he is just sitting there, and Manmatha, the moment he saw him, sarastam, sarastam api धनुः न अलक्ष्यत. हि डिड् नाट् इवन् लुक् एट् हि वास् सो काट् अप् बै द सीन् दट् शिवा वास् शोयिङ्ग् हि वास् पर्फार्मिङ्ग् हिस् तपस् शिवा वास् डूयिङ्ग् हिस् तपस् एण्ड् वेन् मन्मथ केम् देर् टु दट् प्लेस् एण्ड् हि सा शिवा his hand shook and the bow fell down from his hand. He didn't even notice that bow that fell down from his hand. After that, he didn't know what to do. Completely his entire viryam nirvana bhuyishtam, it is completely gone. Atha asya nirvana bhuyishtam viryam nirvanam, it is completely gone, destroyed viryam. His prowess, his courage was gone. Manmatha's courage was completely gone. He didn't know how to attack Shiva and how can I bring about Shiva to even look at Parvati. Then suddenly Parvati comes. So as he describes Parvati, the description of Parvati itself, first she's so beautiful, and then as she comes near, he will start describing her ornaments and all that, and then he will feel, you know, I can easily win over Shiva, if this is the person, if this is the Alambana Vibhava that I'm talking about. And the Uddipana Vibhava Madhumasam to Atra Vartate Eva. Madhumasam to Atra Vartate. So then there is no, he regains his confidence on seeing Parvati. Okay, Nirvana Bhuishta Madhasya Viryam Sandhukshayanti Eva Vapur Gunayena. It is like her body is trying to, you know, bring about his viryam, sandukshayanti, it is punar ucchivayati eva. It is giving him courage. When Manmatha looked at the form that is there in front of him, Parvati's form, such beauty he had not seen. And that beauty, it was like, he regained his confidence to attack Shiva there. So, anuprayata vanadevatavihi adrishyata sthavara rajakanya. Adrishyata sthavara rajakanya. Sthavaram is sthavara rajaha is Himavan. Himavat putri tatra anuprayata. Devatavihi anuprayata. She was being followed by the vana devata. By none other than vana devata. You know, the vana devata itself is a representation of the beauty of the forest. And even if they were beautiful, she looked much more beautiful than her. So her vapuhu sandukshayanti. So that was, it was as if her form was giving him confidence. Then that becomes the perfect alambana vibhava in this scene to give rise to shrungara rasa. So sampurna ityado sampurna alambana uddipana vibhavata yogya swabhava varnanam. So you have that alambana vibhava and uddipana vibhava. Yogyam means it is meant to be an alambana vibhava. So vanadevatabhi anuprayata sa gunena vapur gunena vapushaha gunena vapushaha utkrishta gunena manmathasya viryam sandukshayanti vasasti. That is the appropriate uchita vibhava varnana. Whereas in Evamvadini Devarsho, you don't have such a vibhava varnanam there. There is nothing there. He just says, you know, Shiva has been doing tapas in your garden, and you have to, you know, let her go and serve Shiva. That is one thing. Or Anurupa Pati, you have to, he gives an Ashirvadam, right? That you will get a good husband. So all of these things does not give you a strong vibhava idea in your mind. It doesn't give that alambana vibhavam or the uddipana vibhavam. For the uddipana vibhavam, the entire third sarka, right from the time when Manmatha enters the forest and spring affects the entire people and the forest and the people in the forest, that is your alambana uddipana vibhavam. That kindles the effect, and our sthayi bhavam, the shringara rasam or the rati sthayi bhava in our mind, it becomes udbhutam. It slowly takes form in our mind also as we read the description. Pratigrahidum pranayi priyatvatna, the scene comes. So she is followed by all the vanadevata, and Parvati enters. Shiva is there. He opens his eyes, and Parvati, she has made a garland and she is going to give it to Shiva. So that is your anubhava. So pratigrahidum pranayi priyatvat त्रिलोचनस्ताम् उपचक्रमे च सम्मोहनं नाम पुष्पधन्वा नाम च पुष्पधन्वा धनुषि अमोघं समदत्तबाणम्. ही सॉ दैट दिस वाज द राइट टाइम टू शूट एन एरो. वाट वाज हैपनिंग? त्रिलोचनः तां प्रतिग्रहीतां प्रणयिप्रियत्वात् तां प्रतिग्रहीतुम् उपचक्रमे च तां ऐ थिंक इट इज माला ऐ एम नॉट श्योर सरक् सरक् सूत्रकल्प स्थायि चर्वण विल रीड दट पैराग्राफ आल्सो अगेन. सो ही वाज अबाउट टू टेक दट माला फ्रॉम हर हैंड प्रतिग्रहीतुम् बिकॉज हाउ वाज इट गिवन प्रणयिप्रियत्वात् आउट ऑफ एन अफेक्शन शी हैड made that garland and she was giving it to Shiva. Pranayi priyatvat pratigrahitum trilochanaha tam upachakrame he approached her. At that point of time, what happened? Pushpadhanva manmathaha sammohanam nama amogham banam. Amogham, it has never seen failure. That bana, which is called a sammohanam nama astram, bane, you know, he has five pushpa banam. He has five types of flowers as arrows, but then he used sammohanam nama astram. It became an astra when he invoked a mantra in it. So after mantra japam, it became an astram, which was called sammohanam. Even the name of that astra is so appropriate and apt here. Sammohanam means that which completely confuses or deludes a person. Mohikke vekkirudhu nu artham. Abadi adu eppadi solradhu adu English la enakku varave illa. Sammohanam nama amogham baanam. Adukkuriya thavaradhu. लक्ष्यात् सर्वदा न अपगच्छति इति अमोघः. इट् विल् आल्वेस् हिट् इट्स् टार्गेट्. तादृशं बाणं पुष्पधन्वा धनुषि समदत्त. हि जस्ट् केप्ट् दट् बाण. हि हेड् नाट् इवन् शाट् दि एरो. ओके, दट्स् द बिल्ड् अप् हियर् एण्ड् द ग्रेट्नेस् आफ् मन्मथ इस् आल्सो देर्. सो हि हेड् जस्ट् टेकन् दट् बाणम् अण्ड् प्लेस्ड् इट् आन् हिस् धनुस् धनुषि समदत्त. हि हेड् जस्ट् अपि कोप्तम् अवलोदम् இன்னும் புல் பண்ணல. ஹரஸ்து கிஞ்சித் பிரவிலுப்த தைரியத்யனேன விபாவதா உபயோகா உக்தஹ. த உபயோகம், தட் இஸ் த யூஸ்ஃபுல்னஸ் ஆஃப் த விபாவ அண்ட் தி அனுபாவ. அனுபாவம் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோகம் ஆல்சோ இஸ் அனுபாவ. ஹியர் இட் இஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஹவு ஹி ஹஸ் யூஸ்ட் தி உத்தீபன விபாவம் அண்ட் தி ஆலம்பன விபாவ ஃபார் ஹிஸ் பர்பஸ். மன்மத ஃபார் ஹிஸ் பர்பஸ் பிகாஸ் kuryam harasya pipinagapanehe dairyachatim. That was his pratignya at Indra's court. He made the promise and said, you know, whichever girl or whichever apsaras, whichever rishipatni you want, I will make her come and serve you. Kuryam harasya pipinagapanehe pinagapani. He may be pinagapani, I may be just a pushpadhanva. I am after all having only flowers as arrows, and he is Pinakapani. He has Pinaka as in his hand as a weapon. Even if he is Pinakapani, I will make him diffident, or I can easily shake him away from his resolve. That was the pratignya that Manmatha had made in the court. So here, sammoharam nama pushpadanva dhanushi amogham samadatta vana. What happened? The result of that was हरस्तु किञ्चित् परिवृत्तधैर्यः चन्द्रोदयारम्भ इवाम्बुराशिः उमामुखे बिम्बफलादरोष्टे व्यापारयामास विलोचनानि. ஐயோ, தமிழ்ல சொன்ன ஓஹோன் இருக்கும். சரி, கிஞ்சித் பரிவிருத்தைரியா ஹரஹ சிவஹ. ஹிஸ் தைரியம், ஹிஸ் கான்ஃபிடென்ஸ் வாஸ் ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்லைட்லி ஷேக்கன். கிஞ்சித் பரிவிருத்தைரியா, இன்ஃபேக்ட் தேர் இஸ் அனதர் ரீடிங், கிஞ்சித் பிரவிலுப்த தைரியா தைரியச்சுதிஹ ஏவ அபவத் இதி. தட் இஸ் அனதர் ரீடிங் தேர் ஆக்சுவலி, பட் வி வில் ஜஸ்ட் டேக் இட் இன் அ வெரி டிக்னிஃபைட் மேனர் அண்ட் சே பரிவிருத்த தைரியா. ஹிஸ் கான்ஃபிடென்ஸ் வாஸ் ஸ்லைட்லி ஷேக்கன், ஜஸ்ட் லைக் அம்புராசிஹி யதா சந்திரோதய ஆரம்பே யதா அம்புராசிஹி கிஞ்சித் பரிவிருத்த தைரியா பவதி. தேர் இஸ் ஒரு ஒரு ஸ்லைட் கொந்தளிப்பு, தேர் இஸ் அ ஸ்லைட் எப்படி சொல்றது, இட்ஸ் நாட் அ ஹை டைட், பட் ஓஷன் ஸ்லைட்லி மேக், தெர் இஸ் அ ஸ்லைட் சேஞ்ச் இன் தி ஓஷன் ட்யூரிங் த மூன் ரைஸ். ஜஸ்ட் லைக் தட் So imagine the gambhiryam of samudram. Shiva has that sort of a gambhiryam in him, and for his dhairya to be shaken, how that sammohana astram, just the effect of that sammohana astram just being attached to the bow itself and not even being shot. So the greatness of Manmatha is also seen here. So kinchit parivritta dairyaha katham yatha chandrodaya arambe amburashihi yatha parivritta dairyaha bhavati tatha. So what did Hara do? What did Shiva do? Umam, okay. Bimba phala adhara oshte. Adharam oshtam cha bimba phala viva raktam adhara oshtam. So her not only on her face, umam, okay, but more specifically on her lips. Lips which were like the bimba fruit. Bilochanani vyaparayamasa. All three eyes. So his third eye was also open at that point of time. One, he was so eager to look at her because of the effect in that atmosphere, because of the Uddipana Vibhavam. He was eager to look at her. So the third eye also opened and he looked at her. At the same time, he was affected by that situation and he wanted to destroy that attraction. And so the krodham also, that is very sudden there. So that doesn't have the vibhava, anubhava and etc. When you go to krodham prabho sammara sammareti, there you don't have the vibhava, anubhava for bhayanaka or raudra or anything. So you will stop with this and then the story proceeds as to how Manmatha was destroyed and all that. So, Uma Mukhe Bimba Paladaroshte Vyaparayamasa Vilochanani. He just looked at, with an eagerness to look at it. Chumbanarthe. So, that is why he looked at her. With all the Vibhava, Anubhava and Vyabhichari Bhava and the Uddipana Vibhavam. Sorry, mainly Uddipana Vibhavam. You find there is no sandeham here whether he just looked at it with curiosity or he wanted to kiss her. It is chumbanarthe eva vyaparayamasa. It becomes more clear that it is chumbanarth when you look at the previous shlokas. So atrahi bhagavatyaha prathamameva tat pravanatvat tasya cha idanim tad unmukhi bhutatvat pranai priyataya cha pakshapatasya suchitasya gadi bhavat Rati Atmanaha Stai Bhavasya Autsukya Avega Chapalya Harshadehecha Vyabhicharinaha Sadharani Bhutaha Anubhava Vargaha Prakashitaha Iti Vibhava Anubhava Charvanayeva Vyabhichari Charvanayam Paryavasyati. You have Vibhava Anubhava, you're enjoying that Vibhava and the Anubhava, and you suddenly understand when you say harastu kinchit pravidupta dairyaha. At that point you understand the avegam, autsukyam. He wanted to look at her. Vyaparayamasa vilochanani kutra bimba phala adhara oshte umamukhe. Not only umamukhe, bimba phala adhara oshte api vyaparayamasa. That is the autsukyam there. Chapalyam, he wanted to kiss her. So he, that pravirupta dhairyaha, his dhairyam was gone, his tapasi nirataha iti niratatvam gatam tatra, and then there is that ratyatmakam comes there. It is being replaced there. Harsha, he is happy to receive that pranai priyatvat. Pratigrahitum upachakrame, he makes a gesture to accept her mala that she had. Ya mala taya gratita tam pratigrahitum. Upachakrama, he went towards her, right? That also shows the outsukyam. And then Harsham, he was happy to receive a gift from her. All of these Vyabhichari Bhava, we can understand from the proper delineation of the Vibhava Anubhava here, right? Only then we can understand the Shringara Rasam from this. Or the Vyabhichari Bhavam, you can even say it is a Bhavadvani here, instead of, if you don't need to go to Shringara Rasam here, we can also say it as Bhavadvani instead of Shringara Rasam. Rati is beautifully seen. So Bhagavatyaha Pratamameva Tatpravanatvat. Tatpravanatvat means it is Hara Asaktihi Asti Tatpravanatvat. She is involved, or she likes Shiva very much. That is why she comes and serves him, and she thought she could attain him. Right, tatpravanatvat tasya cha idanim तदुन्मुखीभूतत्वात् तस्य च शिवस्य हरस्य तदुन्मुखीभूतत्वात् पार्वती उन्मुखीभूतत्वात् ही हेड् आल्सो प्रतिग्रहीतुम् उपचक्रमे ही हेड् अप्रोच्ड् हर् एट् दिस् पायिण्ट् सो यु सी द सीन् हियर् रैट् सो प्रणय प्रियतया च पक्षपातस्य सूचितत्वात् नाट् ओन्ली हेड् ही जस्ट् अप्रोच्ड् हर् he also wanted to take that garland from her because of pranayi priya pranayam is out of affection so she has been serving us for so long and he is affected by it that is affection right it's not it's a sneham and you are affected by that situation here so he is also he wants to show his that he likes he is not averse to it सो पक्षपातस्य सूचितस्य गाडीभावात् दट् स्नेह इस् अद् अपडे नल्ल गाढमा पेडुत्तु इट्स् मोर् थिक् हियर् यू केन् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् द इण्टेन्सिटि आफ् दट् स्नेहम् दट् इस् देर् वेन् ही सेस् प्रणयप्रियत्वात् प्रतिग्रहीतुम् उपचक्रमे ओके रत्यात्मनः स्थायीभावस्य नौ वाट् हेपन्स् टु द स्थायीभावं रति औत्सुक्य आवेग चापल्य हर्षादेः व्यभिचारिणः साधारणीभूतः न व्यभिचारि भाव आर् इन्सैड् द स्थायी भाव एण्ड् इट् कीप्स् कमिङ्ग् अप् एण्ड् डौन् दट्स् वाट् इस् द डेफिनेशन् आफ् व्यभिचारि भाव रैट् स्थायी इस् समथिङ्ग् विच् इस् स्टाग्नेण्ट् आर् रति इस् देर् इन् मै मैण्ड् वेन् ऐ एम् फेस्ड् वित् औत्सुक्यम् आवेगं हर्ष चपल एक्सेट्रा it just intensifies the rati gets intensified and I can also experience these different vyavichari bhavas only when that rati is present in my mind sadharani bhutaha it becomes one with the vyavichari bhava sorry the anubhava vargaha prakashita now the anubhava is seen here as how to say see that pranay priyatvat pratigrahitum is actually anubhava but that anubhava has become combined with the vyabhichari bhavas because it gives rise to all those vyabhichari bhavas as a vyangyam we understand it because of our rasikata because we are sahrdaya here or through anandavardhana we understand all these vyabhichari bhavas anubhava vargaha prakashitah iti vibhava anubhava charvanayeva vyabhichari charvanayam paryavasyati that by enjoying vibhava and anubhava it leads us to the enjoyment of vyabhichari bhava vyabhicharinam paratantryat eva srak sutra kalpa sthayi charvana only when the vyabhichari is pinnacle point is your sthayi bhava charvana is the enjoyment of sthayi bhava or rati right srak sutra kalpa sthayi means you have many different flowers and there is one thread that goes in that mala right that sutra eva sthayi bhavah vartate you understand the importance of that sutram when the udriya irukirche pookal you know when you have separate flowers it is not so beautiful but when that sutra comes and joins it you understand the importance of the sutram at the same time you can also appreciate the beauty of the different flowers the vyabhichari bhava is like that sthayi bhava is the sutra is the thread inside the different flowers so there are so many different vyabhichari bhavas that we saw autsukya chapala harsha etc these all have that underlying sthayi bhavam in it sthayi charvana visrantehi alakshyakramatvam we immediately enjoy when you as soon as you read and understand the meaning of the three shlokas you immediately understand the beauty that is there in the shlokam but that is the alakshyakrama you don't understand the kramam there is a kramam what is the kramam we analyze it and later only we come about with the kramam iha tu means padmadala gananam in that evam vadini devarshau padmadala gananam adomukatvam cha anyatha api kumarinam sambhavyate it is not only lajja she is just bored can also be a reason for her to keep counting na lajjayam visramayati hridayam we don't immediately go and understand that it is only lajja so she can also be bored right this is more like a sandeha व्यङ्ग्यम् ओके अपि तु प्राग्वृत्त नौ वि गो टु द काण्टेक्स्ट् हियर् सो प्राग्वृत्त तपश्चर्यादि वृत्तान्त अनुस्मरणेन तत्र प्रतिपत्तिं करोति इति क्रमव्यङ्ग्यता नौ देन् विल् हाव् टु लुक् एट् आल् द विभाव अनुभाव जस्ट् हरस्तु किञ्चित् प्रवलुप्तधैर्यः इस् इनफ् फर् अस् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् देर् इस् अ चपलता इन् शिव दट् इस् अलक्ष्यक्रमव्यङ्ग्यं देर् इस् लीलाकमलपत्राणि गणयामास पार्वती इस् वि नीड् दट् एवं वादिनि वाट् डिड् हि से एवम् उक्तं महर्षिणा किम् उक्तम् इति उक्तिं विना विदौट् दट् वर्ड्स् दट् देवर्षि सेड् वि आर् नाट् गोयिङ्ग् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् लीलाकमलपत्रम् इस् ओन्लि लज्जा अण्ड् नाट् दट् शी इस् बोर्ड् वित् एव्रिथिङ्ग् इट् इस् अ बोर् சும்மாவனும் பண்ணும்ல கை போட்டு அந்த மாதிரி சோ தத்ர பிரதிபத்திம் கரோதி இது க்ரமவ்யங்கதா ஏவ ரசஹா து அத்ராபி தூரத ஏவ ரசம் இஸ் நாட் அட் ஆல் பிரசன்ட் எனிவேர் ஹியர் வியபிசாரி ஸ்வரூபே பர்யாலோச்சியமானே பாதி இது ததபேட்சையா அலக்ஷ்ய க்ரமதா ஏவ இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு கன்சிடர் த ரசம் ஆஸ் This is a vyabhichari bhava lajja that leads to shringaram later during the third sarga. Then probably when you take it at a macro level and consider the entire kavyam, then you can say that it is alakshyakrama vyangyam and this also contributes to it where she was also feeling shy before and now she approaches Hara. And at this point, it's the Shringaram that is revealed and that is also a contributor, but it is too far-fetched for us to connect the first sarga to the third sarga because the second sarga, there is where, people who come and ask Vishnu what to do, you know, Tarakasura is troubling us and all that, Brahma, they come and ask Brahma, all that interlude is there in between for us to connect the first sarga with the third sarga. Whereas in the third sarga, in a connected manner, there are a couple of shlokas which reveal us the vibhava, anubhava, etc., leading us to the vyabhichari bhavam and then rasapratiti. पर्यालोचमान अलक्ष्य क्रमता एव लज्जा अपेक्षया तु सो वेन् वी वाण्ट् टु कन्सिडर् एवमादिति देवर्षौ एस् रिवीलिङ्ग् ओन्ली लज्जा एस् अ सजेशन् देन् इट् इस् लक्ष्यक्रमत्वम् एण्ड् इट् इस् अर्थशक्ति उद्भवम् अमुमेव भावम् एव शब्दः केवलशब्दः च सूच्यते फर्गेट् दट् नो सो इह तु सामर्थ्याक्षिप्त व्यभिचारिमुखेन रसप्रतीतिः तस्मात् अयम् अन्यः ध्वनेः प्रकारः सामर्थ्याक्षिप्त मीन्स् अर्थसामर्थ्य आक्षिप्तः व्यभिचारिभावः तद्व्यभिचारिभावमुखेन रसप्रतीतिः कम्स् अबौट् लेटर् नाट् हियर् सो तस्मात् अयम् अन्यः ध्वनेः प्रकारः मीन्स् दिस् इस् अर्थशक्ति उद्भवः where there is no artha shakti udbhava, this is a counter example that he gives. Yatra cha, that is for swa uktim vina, right, where uktya niveditam. If it is said very clearly, then there is no chamatkaram there, then the dvani does not gain chamatkaram. So yatra cha, shabda vyapara sahayaha arthaha attantarasya vyanjakatvena upadiyate, सः न अस्य ध्वनेः विषयः अस्य अर्थशक्ति उद्भवध्वनेः विषयः न भवति यत्र इन् दट् काव्यं वेर् शब्दव्यापारसहायः अर्थः वि नीड् द वर्ड्स् वि नीड् द हेल्प् आफ् द वर्ड्स् टु गिव् अस् अ मीनिङ्ग् एण्ड् वित् द वर्ड् एण्ड् द मीनिङ्ग् इट् गिव्स् ऐ अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् अनदर् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ अर्थान्तरस्य व्यञ्जकत्वेन उपादीयते दट् इस् नाट् अर्थशक्ति उद्भवम् वि लुक् एट् दि एक्साम्पल् एण्ड् यु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् सङ्केतकालमनसं विटं ज्ञात्वा विदग्धया हसन् नेत्रार्पित आकूतं लीलापद्मं निमीलितम् नायिका कामुका वाण्ट्स् टु अप्रोच् अ नायिका सङ्केतकालमनसं विटं ज्ञात्वा She understands Vidagdha. The Nayika is very clever and she understands what this Vita wants to know. Vitaha is like a Rahasya Kamukaha. So she understands what is there in his mind. He wants to know, when do we meet? Sanketa Kalam Prichati Saha Vitaha. So Sanketa Kalam Jnatum Yasya Kautukata Vartate Saha Sanketa Kalamanasam Vitam Nyatva Vitam Sanketa Kalamanasam Nyatva. She understands that this Rahasya Kamukaha, knowing that her lover wants to know the proper time, meeting time, or his mind is set on understanding when do we meet, you know, when do we meet. He is always waiting for her to tell him the time. Sa vidagdaya hasan, she understands that and she laughs or smiles. She smiled and what she does is netra arpita akutam leela padmam nimilitam. She has a leela padmam in her hand, the same way leela kamala patrani ganayama sa parvati, in the same way she has a flower in her hand. Netra arpita akutam, akutam is ingitam, it's a gesture with her. She shows a gesture with her eyes and says, no, look at the kamalam. And she closes it. Leela padmam nimilitam. So it means when yatha yada leela padmam nimilati, or yatha yada padmam nimilati. So which means when the surya astamanam bhavati tada sankochayati. Right? This lotus also fades illa, it closes itself, that is the time that she is indicating. So netra arpitam akutam and then leela padmam nimilitam, that akuta shabda itself, it actually expresses that she is using that gesture to indicate some other meaning. So as an indication, she shows that her netra arpita akutam yat leela padmam tat leela padmam vimilitam. By revealing, by using her eyes as a gesture, she shows that padmam as closed and smiling. All of that, let us meet in the evening time. That is your Sanketa Kala. That Sanketa Kala is suggested by the Akuta Shabda itself, and that it is not Shabda Shakti Udbhava also, because that Sayam Sandhya Eva Sanketa Kalaha Iti, that there is no Chamatkara Yuktam there. But it is a nice Vyangyam, but the Vachyartham is more beautiful than the Vyangyartham. Yeah? If the Vachyartham is more beautiful, then this is a Gunibhuta Vyangyam. This is more of a Gunibhuta Vyangyam than a Artha Shakti Udbhava Dhvani. Because there is a Shabda Vyapara Sahayaha Eva Artaha. We need the help of Akutam. We don't need the help of Leela Kamala Patrani there for us to understand Lajja. We need it, yes, in the sense it gives the Vachyartham. The Vachyartham is fine. She is doing some work. That's all. And then because of the force of context and everything, we understand from the meaning of that she feels shy. Here, the suggested meaning is only Sayam Sandhya or Sayankalaha. That Sayankala, Kamala Nimilanam, happens only during Sayankalam. And she is suggesting that as a time. And this is her answer, is expressed clearly by the word Netrarpita Akutam. Akutam. Okay. So here there is no atra leela kamala nimilanasya vyanjakatvam uktya eva nimeditam. This is said by the word itself. The word is akutam here. Akutam iti shabdasya uktya eva sayankala sanketaha uktaha. Okay, we'll stop with this. Next section is actually that swashabda ukti. Where and all is that swashabda ukti? He just says shabdartha shaktya kshipto api vyangyaha artaha kavina punaha yatra avishkriyate sva uktiya sa anya eva alankritihi dvanehe. The difference between dvani and alankara, where if there is a sva ukti, shabda shaktya artha shaktya shabdartha shaktya api akshiptaha vyangyartaha, if it has been mentioned by the kavi like this akutam, or in drishtya we saw another shlokam, right? Drishya, Drishtya Keshava Goparaga Hridaya Kinchinna Drishtam Maya Teneiva Skalitasi. In that he also said Sa Lesham Gaditaha Iti, that Sa Lesham word indicates that it has been expressed. So which means we have to understand the double meaning. There is no Vyangyam there. It is only an Alankara. It is only a Virodhabhasa Alankara, or what is that? Slesha Alankara, right? Samarthya Akshiptam Shabda Shaktiya Prakashate. So that is, this is not Emam Jati Agaha Sarvaha Bhavatu Kamam Vachya Sleshasya Vishayaha. In the Vakyartham also, in the Vritti, he says that Vachya Sleshasya Vishayaha. So he is going to pick out, now Ananda Vardhana will give us examples of where Shabda Shaktiya, Artha Shaktiya, Adhava Shabda, Shabda Artha Shaktiya, if there is a Vengyartha, but the Kavi Sva Uktya, Yadi Kavina Punaha Yatra Sva Uktya Prakashi Kriyate, if he mentions it and expresses it in the shloka itself. Saha Asmat Saha Shlokaha Asmat Anuswana Upama Vingyat Arthashakti Udbhavat Anyaha Yeva. It is different from Dvani and it is called an Alankara. Alakshakrama Vyangyasyava Dvanehe Sati Sambhave Saha Tadrik Anyaha Alankara. Even if Alakshakrama Vyangya is possible, it still, we take it as an Alankara because the poet has mentioned it in the shloka itself. Okay. Now he will give us examples for that. Those examples we'll deal with next class.